Good morning. It's Monday, February 4th, 2013. My name's Stephen Whiteside, and I'm your host this morning for today's edition of Canadian Stock Market Trends. Coming up to 7 a.m. on the East Coast, stock index futures are fairly flat, commodities are a little below fair value, so we are looking for a quiet open at 9:30 Monday morning. Well, good morning, everyone. I understand some of you might be a little groggy this morning, so I will take things slowly, but rest assured the coffee will kick in soon enough. If you've been watching the financial media or listening to the financial media over the past week, you know that the U.S. market is up at all-time highs. That's not the same situation for the Canadian stock market. And so this morning, I thought we'd take a couple of minutes and look at some longer-term charts. Any monthly charts that you see in this presentation are handmade, and they're not available on the website. This is not something that I usually post, but let's take a look at a couple of them this morning. Let's start off on the left-hand side of the chart, and you can see where the TSX peaked during the dot-com bubble up at 11,250. If we follow that line along, you can see recently that that level has acted as support, and so that would certainly be a big tell if the TSX was to come down and break through that support. That would probably tell us we're heading back down towards the 2008 financial crisis lows. Now, we've only been able to move up one line, and so obviously the TSX, the sub-indexes are not all going in the same direction right now. Let's blow this chart up a little and add a couple of trend lines. And so if you're bull, you're happy to see that we've been making higher lows, and that's a bullish sign. If you're a bear, of course, you see that we're making lower highs. And if you add these trend lines, you can see that the market's working itself into a triangle here. And of course, a breakout above the downtrend line would be bullish, a breakdown below the uptrend line would be bearish. And we're nowhere near breaking through either of those lines right now. But as time passes, the market's going to be forced to make a decision. And typically when it makes a decision after being forced into or boxed into a corner like what's happening right now, that movement can be quite explosive. So we'll have to wait and see which way the market's going to go next. Looking at a weekly chart, and this is off the website, you can see that we're up here at resistance at 12,812.50, and we've been talking about this number for a while now, so we've traded through it. The market peaked back here in 2012, right around the same level. So we've been trading around that level for a couple of weeks now and have not been able to break away. You drill down and look at a daily chart, you can see that we're stuck to that level while we traded above it. We were still stuck to it. And now over the last couple of days, last week, we've come back down and started to trade back below the 12,812.50 level. Now back to monthly charts, you can see that the financial services, we're not up near all-time highs, but we're up to where we peaked a couple of years ago, and so that's a big concern for me because, of course, that brings back bad memories for people who bought back then during RSP season and have had to hold on for the last couple of years to get their money back. And so here we are up at that previous level, and I don't think we're going to be able to break through right now. Now, along with financial services, the telecom services sector has done incredibly well over the past couple of years, and it has helped hold up the TSX. And so right now we're coming up to the all-time high at 117.90. Last week we got as high as 114.98. So we're getting pretty close to that all-time high, and I would suggest that we'll probably put in a double top up here. This sector deserves a pullback of some sort. It hasn't had one for quite a while. And so the fact that we're getting up to this all-time high might be the catalyst to cause us to at least take a break and have a normal pullback. Whether that takes us lower than that's yet to be determined. But I think the first thing we'll have to deal with is the all-time high. And so we'll have to see how the market reacts to that. Now, what hasn't been working, of course, the Venture Exchange has not been working for quite a while. And of course, when the Venture Exchange is trending lower, that really takes the fun out of the stock market because it tells us that people are looking for the risk off trade, which is financial services, telecom services, REITs, income trusts. That's all risk off. Risk on is where the fun is, and of course that's the venture exchange, that's the energy sector. Look at the energy sector. It's currently trading, you know, back where it was back in 2005. The financial services sector is trading back where it was in 2006, and it looks like we might have to head down here to 250 to find support. Back here, 250 was resistance, then it was support. So now we're seeing if the 250 level is once again going to act as support in 2013. Next up, let's take a look at some weekly charts, and no major changes on the indexes last week or the commodities. Starting with the VIX, is still on a sell signal, which is supportive for higher stock prices. Unfortunately, it was up nearly 10% last week. And so the first warning sign is going to be a weekly close. A weekly close, of course, is a 4 o'clock Friday close above 1619. That would certainly set off alarm bells. No alarm bells for the TSX right now, but certainly this is the time and place to take money off the table and to lock in some gains. And so hopefully you had the opportunity to do that last week before the stock market started turning down. For the energy sector, we're still on a buy signal, a very weak buy signal that started a couple of weeks ago. No change yet. Looking at financial services, we're up at those previous highs, and as we mentioned, it's the time and place to take money off the table. My Bank of Montreal has already generated a daily sell signal. Looking at the gold index, we've been on a sell signal for the last few months. No change there. No change for materials. No change for telecom services. Again, if you've had a winner in this sector, you know, now's the time and place to lock in some profits. You don't have to completely liquidate a position, but it would be good to take partial profits and lock them in while we're up at these levels. Take a look at the Venture Exchange. We're trading in the channel. We've been trading sideways for a few weeks now. A weekly close this coming Friday above 1240 would give us a new weekly buy signal. Next up, let's take a look at some daily charts. And this morning, I thought we'd walk through the leveraged ETFs. Starting with the TSX, we generated a buy signal for the bear ETF on Thursday. On Friday, we traded back into the channel but did not close below the lower channel line. So on Monday, we're looking for a close below 777 to give us a new signal for the bear ETF. For the energy sector, we're in limbo right now. We generated a sell signal for the bull ETF on Thursday, but have not generated a buy signal for the bear ETF. So we need a close for the bull above 529 to get us back into that ETF on Monday, or for the bear, we're looking for a close above 421. Looking at financial services, no change there. Looking at gold stocks, still along the bear ETF, that would change on Monday with a close below 1128. Looking at the S&P 500, still along the bull. Looking at the NASDAQ, still along the bull. Been very choppy the last month or so. We need a close below 2276 to give us a sell signal on Monday. Next up, let's take a look at commodity prices, and no changes on Friday. Crude oil still up and on a buy signal. Gasoline, unfortunately, still going higher. Good if you're trading the commodity, bad for the rest of us. Looking at heating oil, no change there, moved higher. Looking at the natural gas, inside down Friday, traded down a little. Looking at copper took out the recent high, so that's bullish for copper. Looking at gold, traded right in the channel on both sides of the channel lines on Friday, no change there. And silver, still on a buy signal, a close below 31.30 would give us a sell signal on Monday. Next up, let's take a look at my six stocks. No trend changes on Friday. Still long Agrium, no change there. Still short Bank of Montreal, no change there. Looking at Encana, still on a sell signal. We're holding these lows here. If that breaks, of course, then it looks like we're going to run down and test these lows from last April. Taking a look at Goldcorp, no change there, still on a sell signal. Looking at Lumina Copper, no change there, still on a sell signal. And looking at WestJet, ran right back up on Friday. A close above 22.23 would give us a buy signal for WestJet on Monday. Last up this morning, just a couple of 60-minute charts. The VIX came down to the flypaper channel on Friday. The TSX came back to the top of the flypaper channel, a breakout, of course. Would coincide with a buy signal for the TSX once again. We've talked about 12,008, 1250. You can see that we basically got stuck to that line for a week or so. And what was support previously is now going to act as resistance if we head back up again. We're coming into Monday on an intraday buy signal for the TSX, but that would change on Monday with an hourly close below 12,741. Okay, folks, that's all for this morning's presentation. No major trend changes last week that we need to be concerned about, but this is the time and place to be taking money off the table. So if you haven't already locked in some profits, now is the time and place to do so before the market starts to head lower and while things are nice and quiet. So have a great day, folks, and I'll talk to you again next on Tuesday morning.